net in the way that
they were not happy.
People, I mean, I understand they weren't happy. I get it, Jeffrey. But hold on. This affects 7 million people who qualify for these subsidies. So are you saying, really, that President Trump, who says he doesn't want to hurt anybody, would leave these people uncovered?
No, I'm saying Democrats shouldn't let them be uncovered, and they should get with the program and negotiate.
Look, Allison, it's sad. The president sees millions of people that are benefiting from health insurance that are on the ACA, and he sees bargaining chips. He doesn't see lives. He doesn't see that he's putting people in danger. The fact of the matter is, this is a wildly popular piece of legislation that has only gotten popular with the Republicans' attempt to repeal. And so now Democrats are saying, look, we know Obamacare has some issues, and we're willing to work with you to fix those issues. But the administration has yet to come to the table on that.
I just want to challenge what you're saying. How do you know that the president sees these people as bargaining chips? This is how he does it. He says something generally inflammatory, or at least that gets a lot of people's attention, and this certainly got Chuck Schumer's attention, and then he backs off it. So, Symone, I mean, why do you think that this is what we actually would see?
Well, we don't know. I think we've seen a president, Donald Trump, who, you know, says one thing, does another. We don't know what the president would do. All we can go off of is what he is saying. And currently what he's saying is, look, if you don't give me what I want, I'm withholding stuff from everybody, and that is going to actually hurt people. I don't think we can use this inflammatory rhetoric, Allison, when we're dealing with people's lives. Mm-hmm. People with really serious illnesses, from cancer on down the line. So I think we need to just step back, and the president should take a more humane tone and course of action when talking about this issue.
Jeffrey, what about that? That it
Allison?
Does scare people when they hear it. Even if it is just a negotiating tactic, it scares people.
Allison, I want to say something here that I know will probably drive Symone crazy, but think of President Trump as the Martin Luther King of healthcare.
When I was a kid, President
Kennedy did not want to introduce the civil rights bill because he said it wasn't popular, he didn't have the votes for it, etc. Dr. King kept putting people in the streets in harm's way to put the pressure on so that the bill would be introduced. That's what
Jeffrey,
finally
you do
worked.
Understand that you do understand that Dr. King was marching for civil rights because people that looked like me were being beaten. Dogs were being sicked on them. Basic human rights were being withheld from these people merely because of the color of their skin. So let's not equate Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., a humanitarian, a Nobel Peace Prize winner, to the vagina-grabbing President Donald Trump.
Oh, boy.
Symone,
Jeffrey,
President
you did
Kennedy
introduce
did
this.
Introduce
you went there.
Dr. King pressured him to
no,
do that.
There is no similarity. Right. What Donald Trump is doing is he's in over his head. He doesn't understand that healthcare is a complicated issue. He just arrived here. Thank you. Most of us have been here. And he doesn't understand that these are people's lives. So again, I implore the president to take a humane approach.
Go ahead, Jeffrey.
The people whose lives are affected, they talk to me all the time. They're very upset with Obamacare. They want it gone.
Yeah, but if they lose their coverage, they'll be upset also. But Jeffrey, I guess that the point is that the president did say that it's more complicated than he expected. But this has gotten Chuck Schumer's attention. Let me read to you what Senator Chuck Schumer has
said. Oh, no.
Yes, it has. Let me read to you. President Trump is threatening to hold hostage health care for millions of Americans. This cynical strategy will fail. I guess the point is, Jeffrey, is do you think that the president will end up working with Democrats on this new version of whatever he wants health care reform to look like, or will he just cobble this together with the conservative House Freedom Caucus?
I think the president will work with those who are willing to work with him. And if Chuck Schumer is not willing to work with the president, then, you know, that says more about Chuck Schumer than the president.
Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer did send a letter to President Trump noting that they're willing to work with him, that they're ready to work with him on the ACA, and they haven't, you know, to my knowledge, they haven't heard anything back. Look, the fact of the matter is, a Kaiser poll most recently said that the people, the voters, they're going to blame Donald Trump, not the Democrats, if this doesn't work out well.
Okay. Jeffrey, Symone, thanks for the lively debate, as always.
Thank you, guys. Thank